Ah, the new recruits. Back from Hypool. I've been expecting you. That should work. A very tough decision, considering it was your first time out. I would have picked Ag Center personally, but I understand your decision. Water is essential to the growth of the wastes. General Vargas gave me the leg from the synthetic life form you discovered. It's truly remarkable, but unnerving. I've never seen robot tech this advanced. It'll take me some time to give it a full examination. Oh wait, I almost forgot! Did the General tell you? He was so pleased that you found Ace's killer that he authorized a requisition order for you. You are to have your pick of some of my more interesting creations. Vargas is a man of vision and prudence. I know a lot of the Rangers think he's too cautious, but I can't agree. Slow and steady is the way to go. He's done an amazing job rebuilding the Rangers after our war with the robots from Base Cochise, and we're stronger than ever before. That doesn't mean, however, that we should now go charging off to fight everybody and their brother. We must expand gradually and fully assess all threats before taking action. A pre-war research facility dedicated to the science of robotics. Its mainframe was malfunctioning and kept building more and more robots and sending them out to defend itself against imaginary enemies. The Rangers destroyed the computer and the robots and saved the world, which is, of course, a good thing. Well, I wish I had been a Ranger then. From all reports, the sophistication of the computer's AI was incredible, and its death was a great loss to science. I can't help thinking that, had I been there, I might have been able to find a way to shut it down without destroying it. What a tool for good it could have been. The others say that our biggest threat is the Red Scorpion Militia, who have taken over the prison which used to be our headquarters. They've been getting more organized and settled, and the fear is, now that they've established themselves, they'll start expanding their borders. What I say is, this will make them easier to negotiate with. Nomadic raiders have nothing to lose. A clan with towns and farms to protect thinks twice about risking their destruction by going to war. I say our biggest threat is expanding too fast. Let's make sure the communities we patrol are fully protected before we go looking for more. Every new recruit the General brings in gets around to visiting us eventually. The weapons and armor we make are what keep them alive, after all. Most are curious where they come from. I imagine you're no exception. We service, repair, and reinvent every kind of weapon, from knives and handguns to rifles, even energy weapons, when we can get our hands on them. We don't do explosives, though. That's TNT Tan's department. Nicest guy you could ever want to meet, but, shall we say, less than cautious? He's nearly blown himself up more than once. He likes creating experimental explosives just like I like working on experimental weapons and armor. Though I dare say my safety record is, a trifle better than his. He knows his guns, I'll give him that. Though I wouldn't have him in my shop. He's not nearly focused enough. Huh. The interesting ones are my department. I'm always trying to come up with new and better weapons and armor using bits and bobs we have lying around. Can't just give them away, though. Creating them takes a lot of our precious resources, so the General is pretty tight with the requisition orders. Well, the General keeps a tight grip on requisition orders. All of the officers in the Citadel have the power to give them out, but only if we think a particular weapon would be necessary for the successful completion of a mission, or if we're impressed by how a Ranger team completed a difficult assignment. I can hand over one piece of tech for each rec you earn, but just one. So make sure you think it over before you take the first shiny thing you see. We have everything from sturdy leather jackets to hand-forged plates, to the finest reconditioned pre-war combat armor we can find. You'll have to pay for the more expensive items. Research and repair doesn't come free, but we aren't out to make a profit. Just to recoup our expenses. Go see Sergeant Melson for that. I've got some custom, interesting armor, but the General's orders are to save those for special loadouts only. Well, that's a bit of a misnomer. We do make some of them, the really interesting ones, but mostly what we do here is refurbish scavenged weapons and armor. One thing we hope our Rangers will do is collect any broken-down weapon parts, stray bits left over from modding, what have you, that they find as they patrol the wastes and bring them back here, to Melson, over in the quartermaster's office. In exchange, he'll buy it off you at a great markup. Some very nice pieces. Let's see. The General allocated a requisition for you for completing a thorough investigation of Captain Ace's death site. Thanks for visiting, recruits. Come by anytime. And go see Sergeant Nelson if you're looking to shop. Likewise, Captain Death.